Hello everyone, welcome back to Dirt 3 and welcome back to our Dirt Tour. Last time we did a couple of fun races and we got one more left here. That's gonna be a rally cross. Six laps on the first event and then three laps on the second one, it seems. Let's take the Colin McRae Vision car again. It's been good to us so far. The one time we've used it.
You've dominated rallycross race.
Oh, okay, it's this location, huh? Okay. Reach a speed of 171 kilometers an hour. Can I even reach that with very short gearing? I don't know. This is the setup I want. Excuse me, coming through. Of course. I drive into his rear end and I'm the one spinning out. Not him. Okay, so that first corner is apparently a lot tighter than I had anticipated. I need to get this guy though. So I'm ahead now. But for how long? Don't try that. This is lap number 5 out of 6. Drifting through that last corner made some more time and yeah, it was a really nice drift. And yeah, we're gonna win this one. Unless this costs me a lot of time, but well, not enough.
That was awesome. You gotta show that to the world. Put it on YouTube.
I'm putting it on YouTube, thank you. Thank you for reminding me. So, we got one more race in this event. It's gonna be obviously another rallycross and on a different track with only 3 laps. So, I'm interested to see what kind of track this is gonna be. Jump a total distance of 116 meters. High downforce, tip suspension. Maybe leave the right height where it is because of the jumps. Okay, let's try that again. I don't know this track yet. Would you please move in any direction? That felt so good, that drift right there. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to jump for a total distance of 160 meters because I don't have the setup, the car setup for it. I didn't even take off there, really. Couldn't they have just given me an objective of like drift for a total of so and so many meters? Just look at that. Here I'm not even taking off. Okay, that was bad, but probably not bad enough to cost me the win. Neither was this. Like, that was also a really bold maneuver on my part. And I'm sure it lost me some time, but I was far enough ahead to make it work. Whew, okay. We got through. And what do we get? A good amount of rep. Somebody's making loud noises on the outside. I don't know who or why, but I'm sure they've got their reasons. So let's go to the final, to the X Games, where we are gonna start with another Rallycross event. Arena Sprint and Vermont Avenue at LA Coliseum. Let's keep using this Colin McRae Rally Ford RS200. And
let me give you some advice. Oh, who am
I? Yep. I don't know if you could hear that, but those knocking noises are getting kind of annoying at this point. It's okay, we have an engine to listen to here. And that engine is probably, for me at least, with my headphones, is probably louder than those noises. Excuse me, game? You said this track was 100% tarmac, but that right there was surely not tarmac. Like this right here is not tarmac, this is more like gravel. On to the final lap of this race. There's gonna be one more in this event. And we've dominated this one. That's a 157 and, you know, 0.000, that's a flat 157, that is 5.4 seconds out of second place, damn. Yeah. So, it's gonna be LA Coliseum again. Finish without rolling or spinning. Well, doesn't sound like too much of a challenge. But is it? I can see that you might spin in one of these long corners that they want to drift through. Like this one. If you mistime that, I can see that you might spin, but you know, it's not that hard to avoid. Is this just the same track, only the other way around? I think it is. Got that as well. 156.488, so it was faster. We did get the bonus.
Millions of people watching this on TV, and our driver does.
And we're gonna get a lot of rep again. Yes, and we did hit level 15. Flip Off-Road is now interested in us. Alright. Next up is Gymkhana.
I was out getting you an invite to the latest challenge. Ready to win over a whole new batch of fans.
And there's a Gymkhana attack.
Really?
Whoa, lady. Never question a corporate sponsor.
Memorial Park. Alright. We go for the Impreza, I think. I'm gonna go with another river drive car again, like this one, the Saturn Sky by Kenwood. I don't know, I just prefer river drive cars for drifting.
I got a stack of tires.
You get a stack of tires available. That's great, because we're gonna need them for this event. Low down for stiff suspension, low right and strong front. Okay. Let's see. Okay, so this car is a lot faster in a straight line than it first felt like. Okay, so this car understeers quite a lot, on this surface at least. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with another car. Do I even get points for finishing in fourth place? I don't think I am. I don't think I do. So in any case, I think for this event it's better to go for an all-wheel drive car. So that's, yeah, sure. No, let's go with the, yeah, let's go with the Subaru Impreza. There's nothing wrong with an Impreza. It's just that, you know, personal preference, I like rear-wheel drive more for drifting and whatnot. So let's see what we can do with this thing. Let's leave the right height as it is, because this is not tarmac, this is gravel. So actually lowering the right height might give us some disadvantages. Okay. How much better are we doing this time? Are we doing better at all? 4th again, huh? Looks like some pretty difficult competition. I gotta get at least 3rd place here, because otherwise I can't proceed. And I think I might go for slightly less stiff suspension setup. Again, we're not on tarmac, we're on a little bit of a rougher surface. That didn't count as a drift. All right, 2nd. That was better. That was quite a bit better. Almost 50 feet. Oh my god, we were so close to winning this. I'm gonna try this off camera though, don't worry. I'm not gonna spend like 5 hours on this one event. But I had to finish at least 3rd. in order to be able to make progress.
You hear those cheers, amigo? Your fans are going absolutely bonkers.
I know how they feel. You're on the verge of capping off an amazing second season.
Now get out there and bring home the win.
Right, let's go for this. This is another rallycross. Yeah, sure. Let's go with the Ford Fiesta by Flip off-road. Because it's the first car that we can use from Flip off-road. Or at least the first one that we have the opportunity to use. And, you know, Ford Fiestas are quite nice. Reach a speed of 182 kilometers an hour. I'm not gonna go for the shortest possible gearing. All right. Okay, so she's gone through there flat out. That's okay, there are 6 laps. Big jump here. Let's just tap the handbrake for a very short time, just to make that turn a little bit more easily. Things are looking good in this race. Of course, anything can still happen. This is only the 3rd out of 6 laps, and it's pretty long laps. As long as I don't mess up horribly, I should be fine. Even this Ford Fiesta only has 5 gears, and the Fiesta is a pretty modern car. Like, pretty much as modern as it gets in this game. Like, it didn't came out in 2015, and at the point where the game came out, the Ford Fiesta was basically as modern as it gets. And at that point, Kent Buck was also still driving a Fiesta and not his Mustang. At least when the normal Dirt 3 came out. I don't know exactly when Dirt 3 Complete Edition came out, and also when Ken Block switched over to his Mustang. Like, don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure that when Dirt 3 came out, he was still driving the Fiesta. So yeah, that's why it's like everywhere in every single discipline. There's the Fiesta for everything. So this is only lap 5. Holy crap, these are long laps. I mean, comparatively speaking, in this game, of course. Obviously, if we were playing something like, I don't know, a game where races actually take place on real race tracks, like on long tarmac laps, then a lap time of, 53 seconds would be extremely short. And on our final lap we get just a few frame rate issues as a friendly reminder that I should buy a new processor soon. Excuse me? What? Why is this game lagging so much now? What is happening? Is my computer just dying? Well, we've won anyway. It was closer than it needed to be, but we got it. Holy crap, that was weird. That was just awful. But okay, we made it through.
On the big stage, and you blew everyone's doors off.
This is amazing. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks for being proud of me.
Totally. Congratulations, dude. How's it feel to be one of the big dogs?
All right. Let's see what kind of goodies we unlocked from this event, from winning this last race in this season. If we unlocked anything at all. But I'm pretty sure we did. So, first of all, we got some rep. Not enough to take us to the next level, though.
Welcome
by far, not enough.
And congratulations on an amazing Summer X Games.
Mate, you absolutely tore up the track. And on live TV, too.
DC was really impressed by your racing, so they've given you access to the newly upgraded depot at Battersea.
Ah, okay. Well, so that's what you got, huh? Also, I haven't won every single thing there yet, so that's what I'm probably gonna do off camera. So, hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Leave a like or a comment if you did. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.